हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ दी ऑडियो ऑन, दिस इज़ द वीडियो ऑन सॉलिड स्टेट. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. सो हियर वी हैव अ टेबल विथ टाइप ऑफ सॉलिड, कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स, एग्जांपल्स एंड बॉन्डिंग आर अट्रैक्टिव फोर्सेस. द फर्स्ट वन इज मॉलिकुलर सॉलिड. हियर वी हैव थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सॉलिड. वन इज नॉन पोलर, सेकेंड वन इज पोलर हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड सॉलिड. इन द केस ऑफ नॉन पोलर वी हैव ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स एज मॉलिक्यूल्स. द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल फॉर दिस वन इज आयोडीन सॉलिड. द टाइप ऑफ बॉन्डिंग हियर इज लंडन फोर्सेस. अदर एग्जाम्पल्स लाइक आर्गॉन सॉलिड, CCl4 सॉलिड, हाइड्रोजन सॉलिड, CO2 सॉलिड. सो देन कम्स दी पोलर मॉलिकुलर सॉलिड. हियर द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स आर मॉलिक्यूल्स. द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल फॉर दिस वन इज SO2 सॉलिड, HCl सॉलिड. द टाइप ऑफ अट्रैक्टिव फोर्सेस आर डाइपोल डाइपोल अट्रैक्शन. सो देन कम्स दी हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड मॉलिकुलर सॉलिड. इन दिस केस द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स आर मॉलिक्यूल्स. The best example for this one is the ice, H2O ice. In this case, attractive forces are hydrogen bonding. So then comes the ionic solids. Here in this case, the constituent particles are ions. The example for this one is NaCl solid, ZnS and CaF2 and MgO solid. Here attractive forces are electrostatic forces. Then comes the metallic solid. Here in this case, the constituent particles are positive ions and negative electrons. The example for this one is iron, copper, silver, magnesium solids. Here in this case, attractive forces are metallic bonding. Then comes the covalent or network solid. Here in this case, constituent particles are atoms. The example for this one is quartz, that is SiO2, then SiC and diamond. Here in this case, the attractive forces are covalent bonding. Then comes the unit cell. Here in this case, we have three different kinds of unit cell. The first one is simple or primitive unit cell. The constituent particles are present only on the corner position of the unit cell. So this is called as primitive unit cell. So then we have the centered unit cells. We have three different types of centered unit cell. One is body-centered unit cell, and second one is face-centered unit cell. So then comes the end-centered unit cell. In the case of body center, we have only one particle at the center. In the case of face center, we have six particles at the six different faces. So then we have end center. We have two particles at the opposite ends of the center. Face center. So then we have seven primitive unit cells. So let's consider them. So here in this case we have cubic, tetragonal, orthorhombic, monoclinic, triclinic, hexagonal and rhombohedral or trigonal. So let us check what all these things. The first one is cubic. Edge length is A is equal to B is equal to C. Axial angles are alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degree. The best example for this one is NaCl, zinc blend and copper. So then comes the tetragonal. A is equal to B but it is not equals to C. Alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degree. The example for this one is white tin, SiO2, TiO2, CaSO4. Then comes the orthorhombic. A is not equals to B, which is not equals to C. Alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degree. And rhombic, sulfur, KNO3, BaSO4. Then comes the monoclinic. A is not equals to B, which is not equals to C. Alpha equal to gamma equal to 90, but beta is not equals to 90 degree. And the example for this one is monoclinic sulfur, Na2SO4, 10H2O. Then comes the triclinic. A is not equals to B, which is not equals to C, but alpha is not equals to beta, which is also not equals to gamma, which is equals to 90 degree. The example for this one is K2Cr2O7, CuSO4. Then comes the hexagonal. A is equal to B, which is not equals to C. Alpha is equal to beta, which is equals to 90 degree. Gamma is equal to 120 degree Celsius. The example for this one is graphite, ZnO, CDS. Then comes the rhombohedral. A is equals to B, which is equals to C. Alpha is equal to beta, which is equals to gamma, which is not equals to 90 degree. Calcite, CaCO3, HgS, and cinnabar. Then comes the number of atoms in a unit cell. In the case of primitive cubic cell or simple cubic cell, we have eight corners, and the contribution of each corner is 1/8. So for that reason, 8 into 1 divided by 8 is equal to 1 atom. Then comes the body centered cubic. At corner we have 8 into 1 divided by 8, which is equals to 1 atom. At body center we have one more atom, so which will counts to 2 atoms. So then comes the face centered cubic unit cell. At 8 corner we have 8 into 1 divided by 8, which is equals to 1 atom. At face we have a 6 faces. Each phase contribution is half, which is equals to 3 atoms. So for that reason, total number of atoms is equal to 4. So let us consider the close packed structures in 2D. So first we have a square close packing. So it is like this. In the case of hexagonal close packing, we have a 6 atoms at each corner of hexagon. So close packed structures in 3D, 3-dimensional, we'll consider this one, tetrahedral hole and octahedral hole. So in the case of tetrahedral hole, so we have a something like this. So then comes the, for n close packed spheres, the number of octahedral voids is equal to n. For tetrahedral voids is equal to 2n. So for n close packed spheres, the number of octahedral is equal to n, the number of tetrahedral voids is equal to 2n. So let's go to the next part of this one, hexagonal placking. So the type of hexagonal placking is AB arrangement. So this hexagonal placking is also called as HCP. So in the case of cubic close packing, the type of packing is ABC arrangement. So this is also called as FCC or CCP, cubic close packing, or face centered cubic close packing. So we'll consider this one, locating the tetrahedral or octahedral voids. So tetrahedral void will look like this one. 8 tetrahedral voids per unit cell of CCP structure. So in the case of octahedral voids, so this is the case. So let's consider the packing efficiency in HCP and CCP. So both the cases are same. The packing efficiency is equal to volume occupied by sphere in unit cell divided by total volume of unit sphere, means unit cell, into 100. So let's consider this one. Packing efficiency, 4 into 4 divided by 3 pi r cube divided by 2 root 2 raised to 3 into 100. So in the case of CCP, packing efficiency is equal to 74%. In the case of BCC, packing efficiency is equal to 68%. In the case of simple cubic efficiency is 52.4%. The density of unit cell, D, is equal to Z m divided by A raised to 3 divided by Na. Z is number of atoms in unit cell, m is molecular mass, A is unit side length, Na is Avogadro number. So here in this case, the mass of an atom in a unit cell, so that m is equal to m divided by n into A. Molar mass, m is molar mass. So let's consider this one, imperfections in solids. So we have a point defects, so we'll consider that one. So we have a two types of defects. One is Frankel defect and second one is Schottky defect. So let's consider this one. So SEFC, Schottky equal positive and negative are missing, but in the case of Frenkel, only the cations are misplaced. So we can remember this is Schottky and Frenkel with the help of SEFC. Schottky equal number of positive and negative are missing. In the case of Frenkel, only the cations are misplaced. So this is all about solid state. So thank you very much.